awesome ones, Heather here. And these days we seem to be on Zoom calls or we're out in public, and it seems that our eyes are really a focal point. So I thought, I'm gonna do a video on brows, because if you shape your brows properly and, you know, do a little bit of touch up with them, they actually can give you a bit of an eye lift. So right now there's nothing on my brows. I can't wait to get into this tutorial. It all starts in just a few seconds. So the first thing you need is a pair of tweezers. I know most of us have something like this, and it's very important that you pluck underneath your eyebrow and try to keep the natural look of your brow here. Now, I remember in the early days of my modeling how thin brows were so in, and that's the way that I pluck them too, and I probably pluck them a little bit too much, but these days we're going for a more natural look, and I think especially for women of a certain age, it's a great look to have, and this kind of style for the eyebrows that I'm going to show you should last you a long, long time. So I don't know about you, but sometimes I find these weird kind of, I don't know, I call them just straggly hairs that seem to grow out of nowhere. And those wild ones, you can just, it's okay to pluck those ones even if they're on top here. But once we have a good kind of shape with what we've got, we can start getting into the makeup products. Now, the other thing is, I like to pluck my eyebrows at night. I don't like to do it in the morning because I don't want all that redness and everything that shows up. So in this video, I'm going to talk about four different shaping products and fillers for your eyebrows. And number four is by far my favorite, but you know, we all have different kind of eyebrows, so you choose the one that works for you. And I must say that I'm also gonna talk about what color of filler you should use for your eyebrows, but let's get started with where we start. Now, with a pen or maybe a brow pencil like this, you need to just sort of go along the outside of your nose like this, and that is where you're going to start your brows. So right about there. And many of us, that's not where we start our brow. That's not where the hair starts. We got to do a little bit of filling in. And talking about filling in, do not go too dark. I'm going to talk about that a little later on. And also, don't have those big thick brows as well, but we'll talk about that in a second. Let's get to the first product. So the first product that I have here is from L'Oreal, and it's one of those pomades that are really, really popular right now. And what I like about this product, it is waterproof, and the color that I chose is a little darker than, I mean, I'm not going to go silver. That would look kind of, I don't know, it would just look unnatural to do silver brows, so I don't want to go blonde either. It's a little bit too light for me. So what I have with this pomade is 213. It's called Light Brunette, and pretty well every pencil that you get these days comes with a little spoolie like this. Now, this is just like a mascara wand, so if you don't have a spoolie, you can maybe get an old mascara and wash it down really well, but you know, you just kind of brush up the hairs like this. And with this pomade, let me just kind of show you what I've got. Oh, you know what? I wanted to tell you something else. Well, I'm opening this up. Did you know that the old age fairy brings us a bigger nose as we get older? So, you know, we might be moving this along a little bit, but another little perk with getting older, and of course also trying to open things can be a bit of a problem for me right now, but I'll get to it. But the one thing that I don't like about these pomades, and I've tried all kinds of products, oh, and by the way, the products that I have here, I'm going to list them below in the description. If I can't find the exact one, I'm going to get something similar for you, but that way you'll be able to find them quite easily. And of course, we're going to do this. This pomade, once you do get it out of here, it's just like this, and it's just a little cream. But like I say, once you open it, it does really kind of dry up fast, and all you do is you just put this little brush in here like this,
find that spot where I put the dot for the where our brows would be, and you just sort of brush along. I don't know if, Bill, you want me to come to the camera or whether you can see that. The little brush is there, and I'm not going to do my entire brow, but you do get the idea. Oh, and by the way, in case you haven't noticed, as we age, we also, besides the nose thing, we also tend to get more hooded eyes and droopy eyes, downturned eyes, and I have a video on how I give myself a little more of an upsweep with the eyes and the blending. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put the video for hooded eyes at the very end screen of this one so that you can just click on the link and you can help do the rest of your eyes. So the next product that I have here is the Maybelline Ultra Slim. And this particular product, I've got number 255, and I have it in a soft brown. And again, it has the spoolie on the end of it, which is great. Again, for brushing up those hairs. You always want your hairs brushed up. And then see how thin this is really super, super thin. And it's great for filling in. I don't know about you, I got bare patches in my eyebrows. You know, the hairs just seem to fall out of the wrong places. But let me see if maybe Bill can do a bit of a close-up here. And what you can do with a pencil like this is you can actually see the bare patch there. You can actually just sort of brush up a bit like this, and you're filling in the hairs of your eyebrows, so that's a great little trick as well. All right, so the next brow helper that you could use is the standard brow pencil, and this is from Burt's Bees. It's got the little spoolie on the bottom of it here, but see how dull this is. You know, one thing about if you're using a pencil, if it's not a mechanical one, is you need a little sharpener. And what I like about this sharpener is it has two different sizes. So some of those crayon kind of lipsticks or maybe brow wax, it'll fit into the larger hole. But right now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a little sharpening. You don't want to make it super sharp. About like that would be pretty good. And then I'm not going to fill in my whole brow because I want to still show you another product. But basically what you're going to do is you're just going to kind of do your brows like this in order to use the pencil. You're not just going to go swoosh, and you've probably seen women that, you know, just go kind of swoosh like that. No, you want to make a little bit of a feathering with it, and this kind of sharpening works well for that. So let's kind of do a recap, and the first one I showed you was a cream. It's like a pomade. It's waterproof. That was from L'Oreal. The second one that I showed you was from Maybelline, and it was a much thinner kind of brow shaper, especially if you really don't have a lot of hairs in there. You just want to use that to kind of do the feathering. And then the third one is the easy peasy kind of, if you already have your brows, the regular kind of pencil. Now, at this point, I also want to talk about the colors that you use. What you don't want to do is have, like somebody like me, a really dark brown. You're seeing a lot of the younger kind of YouTubers going for darker colors, also kind of squared off here. The only way I can kind of describe it, it's kind of a Groucho Marx kind of look. And for me, women of a certain age, I think it's better if we kind of pull back a little bit and look a little bit more natural. So those are the kind of brows that I prefer. So I told you I had a very favorite brow shaper, and I just found this not too long ago, and it is the Stencil, and it's just incredible. What you do is you buy these stencils, and I know they're hard to find, so I'll make sure I do some links at the bottom. And you also buy its matching powder, whichever powder is the best color for you. And then usually you have like a little applicator. You can use a brush. I've used a brush as well. And all you do is you just put this into the applicator like this. And you place this, remember where we had the end of the brow there? So you do it just like this. Oh, I better make sure I do this right. Hold on for a second. Yeah, that's, let me just see here. That should be good. Okay, and then all you do is you just fill it in And now you know why I didn't want to do my whole brow, because I really wanted to show how great this is. And you just fill it in like that, and ta-da! Bill, can we do a close-up of this terribly incredible brow that I have done here? So isn't that just fantastic? And they come in different kinds of shapes, and of course, I'm choosing the more natural shape. Now, even though our brows look great, it is a powder, so we want to keep it in shape. Now, what we could do is we could use, this is from NYX, and it's an eyebrow wax, and that would work in that little sharpener that I showed you. But what I prefer these days is using the Maybelline Great Lash Clear Mascara, and here's the one that I'm using right now. All I do is I just take some of the excess off, and then I carefully brush up. And what that's going to do is it's going to keep all of the hairs in place, and it's also going to keep that powder in place too. So let's look at the shaped brow, the filled in brow, as opposed to the one that we didn't really do, well, we didn't do anything with that one. And you can see that it's really enhancing the eyes. It is giving the eyes a little bit of a facelift, an eye lift, and also it's just absolutely beautiful for kind of framing the eyes completely. So there you go. There are the two of them together. And don't worry, especially if you're using the stencils, this can be really done quickly. And before you know it, you're just and you're all done. So there you have it. It's time now to bring in scruffy little Hurricane. And little Hurricane, it's overdue for going to the groomers. And so we're going to get him groomed in just a few days. But I still think, even with his scruffiness, he still has the cuteness factor. So I'm really excited to, hi Hurricane, to do more makeup videos for you and trying out products. And also, I have done the capsule wardrobes. As you know, I've done one on casual, one on looking expensive in your clothes, and also just recently on accessories. But I've got two more, and they're going to be surprises for you. I hope you enjoy them. I think you will. And also, don't forget that I'm on Instagram, and what I do over there is I'm posting stories and postings about fashion, but there's an awful lot of inspirational things too there. So, hey, and don't we need a little bit more inspiration and self-care these days? And talking about inspiration, over on our other channel, which is youtube.com/awesomeover50inspiration, I've got some healthy snack eating for you, some recipes for you, and also, you know, how to enjoy the warm weather. And also, we have a really fun video over there, how we redid our backyard in 6.5 hours and made it from drab to fab. So as I mentioned before, I'm buying up all kinds of makeup products for you. And I'm also, you know, I understand that a lot of women, you're on a budget. And so I'm really keeping that in mind as well. And I just got to say, you know, I'm getting in the comments a lot of women saying how happy they are to find me. And it just really, really makes my day. And they're happy that, you know, I'm not in my 20s. I'm actually in my 60s. And, you know, they're happy to find somebody with some wrinkles, with some age spots, with a growing nose, and some patches in her eyebrows. So I gotta tell you, it's indeed my pleasure to be here for you. And, you know, the comments, I read all of the comments. And these days they've got this button that you can just press and it says, hey, glad to help, or thanks a lot, and that. And I don't press those buttons. I really read what you're saying. I think about it. And if I'm going to make a comment, I really choose my words. So thank you for being there. Thank you for making my day. And thank you for making my day a little more awesome.